Hello friends, I, Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am going to talk about bee trees. I have already covered the concept of bee tree, like introduction to bee tree, how to insert new elements, new key values in bee tree, as well as how to search the key element from a bee tree in this video series. Now in this current session, I am going to explain you the delete operation on bee tree, how to perform delete operation on bee tree. Before moving forward, I request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Please share it with your friends. Keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of my new channel. New videos. Now let's start with the bee tree. Now the prerequisites for the deletion of bee tree are the properties of bee tree. You must know the properties of bee tree. So here in this slide, I am going to explain you the properties of bee tree. Here I am assuming that all of you are knowing what is bee tree. Why the bee tree is called as M ordered or M way bee tree, and how to perform insert and search operation on that. So now let's start with the properties of bee tree. Let's go forward by one example. With this example, I am going to explain you all the properties. This is the example of order 4, where the maximum 3 number of keys every node can store, and every node can have maximum 4 number of children. So this is nothing but the 4 order bee tree. Now go forward for the first property, that every time whatever you want to perform insert operation or a delete operation, after performing that, every leaf node must be at the same level. This you need to take care of, where every leaf node will be at the same level. Here you can see that all the leaf nodes, total 9 leaf nodes are there. All that 9 leaf nodes are at the same level. So this we need to take care of the first property. Then the second property, property number 2, deals with non-leaf nodes if it is not root node. So for every non-leaf node, every time the minimum number of keys must be m divided by 2 minus 1, where m is nothing but the order of the tree. Now let's consider this is the tree, B tree with order 4, where m equal to 4. So 4 divided by 2 is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So every leaf node, non-leaf node, must have, minimum number of keys must be 1. And that is 4 divided by 2 is 2 minus 1 is 1 number of keys. Minimum single or 1 number of key must be present. And if m is the order, in that way m divided by 2 number of children should be there. Minimum m by 2 children must be there. So if one key is there, so for one key it's left child and right child, it means minimum 4 divided by 2 is nothing but 2 number of children can be there or must be there. This is the property for non-leaf node, for the minimum number of keys and the children. Property number 3 explains for the same non-leaf nodes if it is not root, but it deals with the maximum number of keys and maximum number of children, how many it could be. So the maximum number of keys must be, for m ordered b tree, it must be m minus 1. It should not exceed the limit, that is m minus 1. And if m minus 1 number of keys are there, it will be having m number of children, because this is the m ordered binary, sorry, B tree, because The order of the B tree is depend on the number of children. So that's why for m number of children, it will be having m minus 1 number of keys maximum. So while deletion or the insertion, while deletion, you need to take care of this property, that is the number of keys should not less than m by 2 minus 1, and equally m by 2 number of children must be there. This property you need to take care of while deletion, and this property you need to take care about or while insertion, because it should not exceed the maximum limit, that is m minus 1 number of keys and m number of children nodes. Let's move forward for the next property, where it is dealing about the root node. Root node, if it is non-leaf node, then it must have at least 2 children. Okay, this is again dealing about the minimum requirement, that is at least 2 children means the root node is having a single key value. If a single key value is there, then it should have at least 2 children. It means that your root must have at least 1 key value and at least 2 number of children. And maximum will again depend on the order of your tree. Now after that, the next property deals about the order in which the keys are going to be stored in every node. Because this is M ordered B tree, where M minus 1 number of keys can present in every node. So that all the values should follow the ascending order in every node. This is the property number 5. So while insertion of the element, we need to take care of this property, where we need to find out a proper position where the order must be in the ascending order. Order of all the keys must be in ascending order. And let's go through the last property, that is for the time complexity of a B tree. For all the operation, that is if it is search, insert or delete, it is big O log N. This is the time complexity which is equal to your binary search tree. Only the difference is that your binary search tree always deals with less number of elements or values, where B tree is specially designed for huge data. If it is huge data, then also it requires the same time complexity as of the binary search tree. It requires same time for searching, for insertion as well as for deletion. So I have gone through all the properties. I hope you must be able to understand what are different properties of B tree and that we need to take care of while different operations. Now onwards, we will focus on the delete operation. So now the delete operation. First of all, in a B tree, we can perform delete operation on any of the key from the node. So it is possible to delete any key from any of the node of the B tree. There are 3 different cases that we need to take care of. So when we want to perform a delete operation, we need to take care of 3 different cases. Which are these 3 different cases that I will explain you one by one in this current video itself. So after deletion, we need to check all the properties, whether if the after deletion, if your B tree is violating any of the property, then you need to take care of that tree must be in the position where it should follow all the properties again. So you have to go through all the cases, because that cases will help you to remanage the tree which will follow the properties again. Because if your tree is not following the property, then we can't say that this is the B tree. Whatever explained in the previous slide, if all the properties are get followed by the tree, then and then only we are going to say that yes, this is the B tree. So all these 3 cases will explain you how to manage the properties while deletion of the any of the element, any of the key element from the tree by making the B tree to follow all the properties. So now the scenario about the number of cases for the delete operation. Here hierarchically I am going to explain you the number of cases. As I explained previously, that total three number of cases we need to take care of. This is the case 1, where sub cases are not available. This is very simple case, and that I am going to explain you very soon. This is the case 2, where sub 3 cases we need to take care of. And for the case 3, again there are 2 sub cases. So total case 1, case 2 there are 3 cases, and case 3 there are again 2 cases. So in total there are 6 different cases we are going to follow to rearrange the B tree while performing delete operation. So now let's start with the delete operation in B tree. So let's consider this is B tree with order 6. Here you must be thinking like whether this tree is following the order 6, because the maximum number of key present are nothing but 3, and the maximum number of children are present nothing but 4. But after performing deletion operation, I will explain you how this tree is going to form the order of 6. Basically or currently, let's only keep in mind that this is the tree is having order 6. It means that this tree, every node can have the maximum 5 number of keys and maximum 6 number of children. So now let's start for the deletion. Now I am going to explain you all the cases one by one. So this is my first case, where if whatever key which I want to delete is a part of leaf node. Okay, if my key which I want to delete is a part of leaf node, then I need to check whether after removing the key which I want to delete, it's not affecting any of the property of my B tree. That is what I explained previously while explaining the property. Property number 2 I need to take care of, where the minimum number of keys it should have, that is if m order tree is there, it should be having m divided by 2 minus 1 number of keys. So if it is following this property, then simply we can remove the key. Let's move forward for the example where I am explaining you the same case with the same tree, whatever I have given in the previous slide. So now let's consider I want to delete this value 6 from my B tree. Now after deletion of 6, the number of keys remain with this node are nothing but 2. The order of this tree is 6. 6 divided by 2 is 3 minus 1 is nothing but 2. So it is not violating any property, that is minimum number of keys present after deletion are 2, and it is okay with the order 6. So simply delete this 6. We don't want to do anything, because simply deleting this 6 is not violating any of the property. So after deletion, my tree will look like this, and my tree is following all the properties as well. So now let's move for the case 2. From the case 2, I am going to explain you the sub case 2a. Now in this case 2, I am going to explain you if my key is a part of internal node, because case 1 where the key was a part of leaf node and it is not violating any property in terms of the number of minimum number of keys present after deletion. Now this is the case 2 where we are going to consider that the key which I want to delete is from the internal node or intermediate node. Now let's consider the first case, that is A, case 2A if I want to delete 19 from the internal node. Now here you can see that after deletion of 19, what will remain with this node? Only 23. So the minimum requirement of number of keys should present in every node, this property is going to violate over here. So what I need to do? I need to, in this particular case, what I need to do? I need to check for both of its child nodes. Because if a key 19 I am going to delete, its first child is having 2 number of keys, its second child is having 3 number of keys. So what this case 2A suggests us, that the node which is having more number of keys, from which we need to select the node which is near to the key value which I am going to delete. I repeat, from both the nodes, I need to select the single node which is having the more number of keys. So this is having 2 key values, this is having 3 key values, from which I will select this particular node. Now what I need to do? I need to select a single key which is near to the value or a key value which I want to delete. Means if I want to delete 19, from this node the key 20, which is the nearest one. So what I will do, I will replace this 90, means I will delete this 90 and I will push up this 20 to this position, which is not violating any property, that is the minimum number of key values are present is in this node after deletion are 2 and are okay with the order 6 tree. After that, all the numbers, all the key values are in the ascending order. This also will get follow with this particular solution. And the numbers or the key values which are present in the left child of 20 are less than 20, and all the key values which are present in the right sub node are greater than 20. So that's why we need to apply this particular solution over here. So after deletion of 19, my tree will look like this, where the 20 is going to take the position of node 19 and it is following all the properties. So in this way, I can perform the case 2A. Now move forward for case 2B. Now here in this case, the same way, where if I want to delete the key which is part of the internal node, that is 13 I want to delete. Just opposite to the previous case, here in the same way I need to check whether the both the nodes, that is left sub node and right sub node of the key value which I want to delete, if it is present at the intermediate node, then I need to check which node is having the more number of keys. Previously it was having the right sub node more number of keys than that of the left sub node. Here in opposite way, the left sub node is having more number of keys than that of the right sub node. Previously it was from the right sub node, that's why the nearest or the first number we chosen for the replacement. Here the left sub node is having more number of values, so I will choose the last number which will be the nearest to the key value which I want to delete. So I will choose number 12 or a key 12 which is going to be replaced with 13 after deletion. Now here you must say that if this after deletion of 13, this node is having 2 key values and are sufficient as far as the minimum number of keys required for order 6B tree. So let me explain you the concept, where if I will delete 13 and only 2 number of keys are present, then maximum number of child nodes present with this node must be 3, correct? But we are having the 4 number of child nodes are available with this node. And if I will not do anything, then it is violating a property, that if 2 keys are present, then maximum 2 plus 1 that is 3 number of keys only present or can be present with that node. We need to follow this property. That's why what we need to do, we need to choose the key value which is nearest to 13, which will get replaced with 13 and which is not violating any of the property. So now let's move to the next slide, where I will explain you that now 13 is removed or deleted from this node and 12 is going to replace its position. Now let's check. If 3 number of keys are present, 4 number of childs are okay. Correct? So this property is not going to be violate. After that, the 12, which if its left sub node is, we are going to consider all the key values must be less than 12, and if the right sub node we are going to consider or child we are going to consider, all the key values must be greater than 12. So in this way, this case 2b is explaining you what to do if this type of situation is there. Now let's move forward for the case number 2c, where again the same thing, we are going to explain you that we are going to delete the key which is the part of the internal node. Time being, whatever I have explained you in case 2a and 2b was either the first key value or the last key value. But if it is the intermediate value, then what we need to do? If it is the intermediate value, then we need to check about its number of keys present in every sub node, that is in its seventh left sub node and the right sub node. If both are having the m by 2 number of keys, then after deletion of this particular node, then what we can do is, after deletion of this particular node, only 2 key values will remain this particular node. It means that the maximum number of children nodes are available are nothing but 3. So to follow this property, what we will do, we will merge both the nodes, that is the node left sub node for 7 is having value 4 and 5, and the right sub node for the node 7 is 10 and 11. I will merge both the nodes and I am going to follow all the properties after deletion of 7. So now let's move to the next slide, where I am explaining you after deletion how my tree will look like. So after deletion of 3, only 2 values are there, and we had merged both the nodes which were left subchild and a right subchild of 7, and all the nodes, that is this one as well as this one, are following all the properties after deletion of the node or a deletion of the key. So in this way, if this is the situation in case 2c is there, then what we need to do, I have explained just now. By merging only, we are getting a solution if this type of situation is there. Now let's move forward for the case number 3a. Now here, it is the key value which I want to delete is not present in internal node, because for the internal node, value if present in internal node, what to do, we have already gone through in case number 2. Now let's move forward for case number 3a, where if the key is not present in internal node, so what we need to do. So now let's consider, I want to delete this 4 from my tree, B tree. Then what I have to do, if you want to delete this 4 from my node, I need to take care of what we have to do. So now let's consider, if you want to delete a 4, its parent node is having 2 key values. So in this situation, what I have to do, that is I will merge both the left child as well as right child of a root node by performing the merging operation. Now my this node is having 5 number of key values, and 5 number of key values means the 6 number of maximum children can be available. So these three again following the order of my tree, which is order 6. And after merging, we are reducing the height of the tree by 1. So if this type of situation is there, after deletion of this particular node, if the parent node is and its sibling are having the number of keys which after merging are following the property or the order of the tree, in that case we are going to merge them to reduce the size or to reduce the height of the tree, because B tree is having low height and that's why this tree is called as fat tree, because very low height can also store the more number of keys, huge number of data. So that's why this tree is called as fat tree. So this was the case number 3A. And what is the case number 3B? Again the same thing, if it is not present in internal node and if I want to delete the key number key 2 from the this node. So if I am going to delete 2, it is violating a property that the minimum number of keys present in the node should be 2 if the order 6 is there. So if order 6 is there, minimum number of 2 key must present over here, then after deletion of 2, it is not from the case number 1, where after deletion of this node, the minimum requirement of number of keys present in a node is not satisfactory. So that's why what I need to do in this type of case. So in this type of case, what I will do, I will shift this 5 from this position to its parent node. It will take the position of 3 and I will shift down this 3 to this first node. After performing all these tasks, your tree will look like this. And now let's check whether this tree is following all the properties or not. That is, after replacing from 5 this position to this position and 3 from this position to this position, the number of minimum nodes from this node as well as this node are not violating the property, that is m by 2 minus 1, that is 2 number of nodes in case of m is equal to 6. So both the nodes are having minimum 2 number of nodes, as well as the order is in ascending order, as well as it is following a property that for the every key value its left child is having, left node is having all the keys which are less than 5 and all the keys which are greater than 5. So all the properties are followed by after performing the delete operation on the key value 2. So if this type of situation is there, you can perform this particular operation. But if here this key is having insufficient values, means if in this case now, if I want to delete 3 from this node, then what I need to do? I need to delete this 3 by merging the node. But in this case, what I need to do? I need to move 5 to downward. I will merge this 1, 5, 10, 11, which will be having 4 key values and which will be the left child of node 12, where all the values will be less than 12. So in this way, what is the situation? You need to apply the particular case and you need to find out a solution. So I hope all of you are getting how to perform the delete operation on the B tree. Thank you friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content of my video, please do not forget to give the comment. Please subscribe my channel. I am providing you subscription link here, as well as I am providing you the shortcut link for the next video of this video series, as well as I am providing you the playlist for this video series. Thank you, friends. Stay tuned and do not forget to subscribe my channel, Tech Talks. Thank you.